We're here to go through setting our new resolutions, step into the imagining of what it will feel like next year when we've actually accomplished the things we want to accomplish this year. And we're going to do that by going through a guided meditation, and then we'll discuss what's in our way, trying to imagine certain goals for next year. So first we'll go through introductions, then we'll go through a brief mindfulness meditation, followed by a guided meditation, followed by discussion, then another brief meditation to just reaffirm our destinations for next year, the feeling of having achieved our goals, and then we'll wrap it up and be able to get going with the destination set for what it will feel like having accomplished your goals. So first introduction. So I want to know who you are and how you found out about this. What led you to come here? Not just how you found out, but why did you actually decide to come to this particular event? So I'm Jonathan, inspirational life guide, author, speaker, and I'm here to lead this for all of you. Which direction do you want to go here? You want to start with Nicole?
You all know me, I'm Nicole. Fight for Fitness is my number one B, besides that one out there. And we were really excited to bring Jonathan in because, I've known him for a decade. Orlando has known him for, since I've known Orlando. And every time we have a conversation with him, he blows your mind at least once. He's really good at what he does. So, we were really excited to share some of the great inspiration we've gotten from Jonathan and everybody's here in this morning.
Hi, I'm Wachtel. I found out about it on the website. I was looking to the town where I was at the end before something else. So I was looking over to see if they had already been dead and what was gone. And I've just been searching for some place like this.
I'm Christine. I've been coming here for a few months now, and I'm doing the Fight for Fitness program in Orlando. And he said so many good things about you, so I had to come check it out.
I'm doing the same program with Christine. I'm Callie. So same thing, Orlando talks a lot about you, and I couldn't wait to come and hear what you have to say as well.
I'm Julia, same group as them. After hearing about getting, mind blown and inspirational speaking, I am very interested in what you have to say and, learning more about health, nutrition, just finding myself in general. I've been coming to the gym for the past year and I want to say maybe halfway to my goal at this point. Every little bit of help counts, so I'm looking forward to further learning.
I'm Audrey. I've been training with Orlando for around a year in Rockaway. I came to support them, and also they talk very highly of you, so I'm interested in what you have to say. He just my driver.
Orlando's been great, fantastic. Even though I have a master's degree in physical education, I've run marathons and so on. She listens to him, I haven't been able to reach up. So, I have his back in all ways.
That's the way it happens. So now we're going to do 3 to 5 minutes of mindfulness meditation, which is going to really lead right into a guided meditation. But what I want you to do for this 3 to 5 minutes is I just want you to breathe and just pay attention to the sensations of breathing. So in this case, like the air as it flows past your nostrils, the rise and fall of your chest as you breathe. Obviously, like if you're having trouble breathing, it's got even more.
I breathe too deeply.
We can just breathe normally and just pay attention to what it feels like to breathe. We're often not paying attention to our breathing. You could do the same kind of thing with walking, with listening to people speak, listening to the words that you're saying, to just be present in the moment, notice what's there. And whenever you notice your mind wander, because it will wander, obviously there are all these distracting things like little cute babies and stuff. So if you notice your mind wander, then just acknowledge where it's wandered to and gently bring your attention back to your point of focus in the present, which is, in this case, the sensations of breathing. So just the air as it flows past your nostrils, the rise and fall of your chest as you breathe, choose a sensation. Whenever you notice your mind wander, just bring your attention back. So let's just do this for 3 to 5 minutes. The idea is to get more into the present, less distractible, more focused, and more receptive to everything else we're going to be talking about, and be able to get more deeply into the guided meditation and the imagining of our having achieved our goals. So 3 to 5 minutes, let's do that now. Just breathe. you're still in this calmer place. You can keep your eyes closed or open, whatever's comfortable for you, but you're going to want to be able to pay attention to what's going on inside you and not outside, so close might be better. While you're still in this calmer place, I want you to think of a time when you felt accomplished. Think of a time when you set out to do something, when you decided, this is what I would like to do, this is my goal, this is what I would like to have done, and you did it. Think of that feeling of accomplishment. It could be anything, it could be big, it could be small, you could go back as far to the past as you want, as you need to. Think of a time when you felt like you accomplished something that was meaningful to you, that you knew that you decided you were going to do this and you did it. You felt that sense of achievement. Fitness-related goal or relationship-related goal. It could be something small, like I'd like to go for a walk today for some reason. That felt like a really important accomplishment that day. Because you decided you were going to do it, you did it. It could be a school-related goal, career-related goal. Decided you wanted to pass the test or get a really high score past a certain point, and you did it. Or graduate from somewhere, or get a certain job, or take a class and complete it, any subject. Could be anything you decided you were going to do, and you did it. Notice what that sense of accomplishment feels like in your body, that sense of triumph, of achievement, of having done something that was important to you. Perhaps it feels like a sort of higher energy state than usual, your usual state of being. Like you're revved up, but in a positive way. A sort of rush of energy. Pay attention to what that feels like for you, what it feels like in your body to have accomplished something. Now project that accomplishment into the future. Let's take it with us forward in time. Imagine it's January 15th, 2016, 1 year from today, from the time that we did this in this room, that we decided what we wanted to accomplish this year in 2015. It's January 15, 2016, and we're looking back at the year that just passed. Let's start imagining some of the things that we've accomplished between now and then that would lead to that sense of accomplishment of having decided we were going to do something that was important to us and actually doing it and looking back and knowing that we did exactly what we set out to do. So let's project this feeling of accomplishment into different areas of our lives. So now in the area of our bodies, imagine feeling accomplished in whatever fitness-related or other body-related goals, body image-related goals you have. Imagine 2016 and you're looking back at 2015 and you achieved everything you would have wanted to in 2015. You are exactly where you would want to be in terms of your body. Perhaps you're exercising regularly or you're more toned or you like how you feel in your clothes or how you look in the mirror. You're proud of how you feel and how you look in your body. That sense of accomplishment. And now in your living situation, imagine you're looking back and it's 2016 and your living situation is exactly what you would want it to be. Maybe you've cleaned and organized your space maybe more regularly than you used to. Maybe you've changed your living situation altogether, maybe you've moved. And you feel like you achieved exactly what you wanted to in terms of your living situation in 2015. To what that feels like and what that would mean for you. Project that sense of accomplishment into your career. Imagine you accomplished everything you would have wanted to in 2015 in regard to your career. You are exactly where you want to be in January 2016. Maybe that means you changed jobs or you changed your approach and your perspective to the present moment. Maybe it means you've created something entirely new for yourself. What would it be like to feel accomplished in your career in 2016 looking back? Project that feeling of accomplishment into the area of finances. Imagine it's 2016 and you're looking back and you're accomplish every financial goal you set out to achieve in 2015 for yourself? What did that feel like? Now project that feeling of accomplishment into the area of family. What would it mean to feel accomplished when it comes to your family? What would have changed in 2015? You're looking back, you're feeling like you really achieved something there in your family. What's improved? And how? Now project that feeling of accomplishment into the area of community. What would it mean to feel accomplished in terms of community? Perhaps you've found a place that you feel you belong, or you've strengthened the belonging you already felt. Looking back at 2015, you feel like you're really part of something much greater than yourself. You know what your role is and you feel good about your role. Come to accept all aspects of yourself. You're increasingly feeling accepted by other people. Now project that feeling of accomplishment into the area of friendships. What would it mean for you to feel accomplished in the area of friendships? Looking back at 2015 and feeling like perhaps you developed much closer connections with people in your life, maybe brought other people into your life you feel really close to. Connected with. Project that feeling of accomplishment into the area of your relationship, or relationships. What would it mean for you to feel accomplished in the area of relationships? Maybe you moved out of a relationship that wasn't serving you anymore in 2015. Building a relationship with yourself. Maybe you moved into a new relationship with someone else who supported you in your relationship with yourself. developed an even closer connection with the person you're already in a relationship with, feeling closer to that person than you've ever felt before. Like you have a partner in life. Imagine it's January 2016 and you're looking back and you feel accomplished in all areas of your life. And nearly every goal you set out to accomplish, every goal you set for yourself back in January 2015, you achieved. What does that feel like to look back and know that nearly every goal you set out to achieve, you achieved in every area of your life? 2015 was such a transformative year for you, even in ways that you didn't imagine could have been the case before. What would that feel like? Let's come back to January 15th, 2015, back into this room. And you can open your eyes whenever you're ready if they're closed. What we were just doing was basically setting emotional destinations for ourselves, because it's the emotion that is the fuel in the car. If you think about it, whenever you set out to achieve any goal, if you really imagine what it would feel like to achieve it, then there's that fuel, that emotion driving you forward that actually gets you to do it, and gets you to accomplish it. Without the emotion, we don't really do very much. If we tell ourselves we have to do things, or we need to do things, then we rebel, we resist. We don't actually do those things. We resist as much as possible. If you say you have to go to the gym, or you have to change careers, or you have to take out the trash, or you have to break up with this person, or you have to make more money, we don't do any of those things. If you think about it, if someone were to tell you that you had to do things, you already know what that feels like. Like there's this immediate resistance, this immediate reluctance to actually do that. So, So what we're doing here, rather than saying we have to accomplish certain things in 2015, we just imagined what it would feel like if it already worked out that way. Now think about it. Our usual approach to things is that we think about what we're afraid of happening. What if I don't accomplish this? What if I still weigh this much, or I still am stuck here in this job, or this living situation, or this income, or this this relationship, this family situation? What if this never changes? We focus on what we're frustrated with, what we're upset with, and that doesn't actually make any change. That keeps us where we are, because it keeps us frustrated, it keeps us upset, it keeps us, you know, not content with what the situation is. So when we're looking at what we're not liking, then we actually just keep doing the same things that keep us not liking what's happening in our situation in life. And then that's when we start to tell ourselves that we have to do things to change that. If you think about it, if you're riding your bike and you're looking at the pole that you don't want to crash into, then you very likely will crash into the pole. Because we go where we're looking. We're naturally inclined to go in life, not just riding bikes, but in life in general, we're naturally inclined to go where we look. If you're trying to get a kid to do something and you look a certain direction, the kid is going to look that direction. If you want a dog to stop biting the couch and you look at the couch and you say, no, bad, then the dog's like, what, couch? I'm supposed to be biting the couch? Because as far as the dog knows, dog's not speaking your language. As far as the dog knows, you're pointing at the couch, putting a lot of energy into it, couch, couch, and as far as it knows, it should have more attention on the couch. So this is true about everyone and everything, not just pets. We all speak the language of attention. We don't actually speak English. We speak the language of attention. You tell your significant other, I don't want you to do this anymore, it really bothers me when you do this. Then they do it again. And it's not because they're trying to bother you purposely. Because you're focusing on that, they're already feeling like you're expecting them to do it again. They don't feel motivated to make a change because you're basically saying to them, I don't have faith in you to make this change. That's why I'm so frustrated with you. And then they do it again because you weren't actually focusing on an alternative. So if you think about it, we really need an alternative. We can't say, I don't like this. We need to say, what would we like instead? Not, I don't want to crash into this pole. But I'd really like to go off to the right to that open field over there. I'm just going to look that direction. I have no reason to force the wheel anymore because now I'm just looking at the open field. I have no reason to look at the pole anymore. So if you see the things that you maybe haven't been liking about your life now, then the next step would be to say, well, what would I like instead of that? That's really what we were just doing. Is rather than saying, I don't like these things about my life, we were saying, what would it feel like if we already did these things and are looking back and we've already accomplished them? Rather than, what if it's 2016 and none of this has changed, which is usually what we do, essentially. We worry about the things that might happen. We sort of anticipate regretting the way we spent our time. You know, like we project regret into the future. We project anxiety into the future, skepticism, doubt, fear, frustration, anger. We focus on those things and imagine that those things are going to be that way tomorrow and next week and next month and next year. Now, obviously, that's just setting ourselves up for failure. It's looking at the pole that we don't want to crash into. So, ultimately, if we were to practice what we were just doing today, or attempting to do today, if we were to practice doing that, where we actually look at where we'd like to go, step into, what if things went the way I wanted them to, and we rehearse that in our minds, then it would be just as powerful as when we're rehearsing in our minds the way things go that we don't want them to go. When we rehearse that we don't want them to go that way, and then they do happen that way, and then we're validated in our fears, because it happened exactly as we were afraid it was going to happen, because that's what we were focusing on, and we sabotage ourselves along the way without even realizing that we're doing that, not being as present to what we're doing, interacting with people in ways that we get the reactions that we're expecting from them, instead of imagining that maybe this time, this interaction goes a little different. What would that feel like if I spoke to my family member, and this conversation actually went well this time? What would that feel like? Rather than, oh, I'm gonna have this conversation, it's gonna go just as badly as all the previous conversations that I had with them, do the same argument as always. What would it feel like if it went differently? That you step into that scenario? Because that's what we're always doing, we're just usually doing it more naturally, reactively, doing it with the negative scenarios. If we were to do it with positive scenarios, and wherever we're doing it with positive scenarios, not necessarily intentionally, we get good results, but this is just sort of zeroing in on, well, this is what you're doing right. It's focusing on where you want to go. That's why things go right. That's why when things are going well for you and you're feeling good, then more things go well. And there's this sort of like, you know, increasing spiral upward. And when things are going badly, then we react to them going badly. We think they're going to keep going badly, we get really frustrated, we put a lot of negative emotional energy into things, and then more things go badly, and then we spiral downward. So we have just as much power at any point in time to spiral upward as to spiral downward, or to maintain where we are. And it all depends really on where we're looking, with our focus of attention, our emotional energy, and ultimately what we're thinking about is causing what we're feeling. So if you really think about it, it's sort of like we have our own internal GPS system, where our thoughts are essentially the destination that we're plugging in. And so that's the address. Then our feelings are like sort of gauging, is this a good destination or a bad destination to go to? Would I feel good or feel bad if I kept focusing on this and actually got there? And also our feelings are the fuel in the car that motivate us to go in that direction. So if it feels good, you're going the right direction, and you're gonna be motivated to go there because that good feeling is gonna keep you doing things that are actually gonna get you where you wanna go. And then our wants, our instincts, our desires are like the directions from the GPS telling us turn right, turn left, go straight, act on this opportunity, talk to this person. It's sort of like gut instinct, like this is what I feel would be good for me to do right now. That's the directions from the GPS. And then ultimately we act on those directions, then we'll get to whatever destination we plugged in with our thoughts. Whatever we were giving our emotional energy to, whatever we were giving our mental and emotional energy to, we'll get there if we act from that place. So basically, whatever you're focusing on, you're going to end up doing a whole bunch of things that support you in feeling whatever feeling you're focusing on. So if you start the day seemingly on the wrong side of the bed, it would be a good idea to take a moment and redirect that feeling. Think, well, what if I had a good day today? What if that happens? Rather than what if this goes wrong and that goes wrong, and what if I'm really upset about how this went, and oh, it already started badly, I can't expect it's going to go any better from here. So ultimately, it would be a good idea, right from the beginning of the day, to redirect that. If you're not feeling good at any point in the day, rather than continuing to just go at things, where we're inclined to just put more energy into things, try to force things the direction we want them to go, from that have to, need to, controlling place. I'll just try to get these people to do these things that I'm expecting they're not going to do. I'm just going to try to force myself into my weight goal by sheer will, which never works, because even if you manage to get there, then you're really upset with everything, and then as soon as you let your guard down, you slip right back to where you're resonant with being, because it's your, what you're focusing on, it's being upset with where you are, that you're giving energy to when you're trying to get there by sheer will. So you can't change things by focusing on what you're upset with, contrary to the way that we're all inclined to do things. We can't actually look at what we're not liking in order to fix it. We actually have to acknowledge what we're not liking and then figure out what we would like instead and look there. Just like rather than don't bite on the couch, that you say every time the dog bites on the couch, you give him a chew toy. And then you pet him and you give him a treat and whatever else. You give him attention when he's chewing the chew toy, not when he's chewing the couch, but when he's chewing the chew toy. So you don't give him attention when he's chewing the couch. You give him an alternative thing to chew and you give him attention for that. We ought to do the same thing for ourselves. If ever we're giving a lot of emotional energy to something, then we ought to say, all right, what would I like to put that energy into instead of this? What would I like to look at instead of this pole? So ultimately, we see what we're not liking, we see the pole, we acknowledge it, and then we say, okay, this is where I'd like to go instead. What would it be like if I went there? What would that feel like? Step into that emotionally. Now notice an important thing here, is we're not saying, I have to be with this person. I have to have this house on this street. That's the only way I'm going to be happy. That's not our goal. Our goal is what it would feel like, what we imagine we would feel if we were with that particular person or with that house or whatever. Because it's not the person or the house that we want. It's really the feeling. And if we're focusing on the feeling, then we'll be more open to letting go if that's not the right person to get us to that feeling. That's not the right house to get us to that feeling. That's not the right approach to career, to getting to that feeling. Maybe that job isn't the one you were supposed to get. Because if you really wanted to get to that feeling, you've set that emotional destination, and now this one doesn't work out, you can actually go forward with confidence that you're on the right track still, because your GPS is still guiding you forward, and it's not guiding you to the job that you didn't get, it's guiding you forward. So as long as you're clear about what you want to feel, and not what specific thing you think is going to get you there, which isn't your job, it's the GPS's job. We don't do that. When we have a GPS in the car, We don't say, well, now I have to go on this street and I have to go on that street, ignoring the GPS. I mean, we do sometimes, but obviously that doesn't work if the GPS is accurate and we're going off, well, I need to figure out where I'm going. I don't care what the GPS is saying. You know, maybe we have the wrong destination plugged in, so we just ignore it instead of turning it off. It just doesn't make any sense. But that's what we do all the time internally. If you're focusing on what you're not liking, and then you try by sheer will to go a different direction, it's like you have a different address plugged into your GPS than you're actually intending to go to. It's recalculating all over the place. You know, like, you know, you're past the street and told you to turn down. It's recalculating. Turn right. Turn right, and you're ignoring it again. You're going forward. Recalculating. Turn left. It's really annoying at some point that you're getting all these directions that are irrelevant to where you're trying to go. But that's what we do all the time internally, which is why our thoughts and feelings are all over the place so much of the time. We're getting all these urges and inclinations to do things, act on things that really aren't in our favor, because we're focusing on all sorts of things that we don't actually want. And then we get directions there, and then we try to ignore them. And then because we're ignoring ourselves, other people ignore us. And then we feel like they're ignoring us, and then we really get upset with other people, that they're not listening. But we were the ones who weren't listening in the first place. That's why they weren't listening to us. Because we set the example for how other people treat us. This is another sort of principle. We have a GPS in ourselves, but ultimately the way we treat ourselves sets the example for the way we're inclined to treat others and the way others are inclined to treat us. Which is a big part of why, you know, doing things by sheer will doesn't ever get us the results that we want. Because ultimately we all want positive attention. We want it in the form of love, money, respect, appreciation, gratitude. We want, you know, when you think about everything that you want, it's all just some form of positive attention. And that's what everyone and everything in the world wants, is positive attention. So if we're setting destinations, focusing on what we don't want, and then we're ignoring ourselves, or scolding ourselves, because we shouldn't be thinking this, we shouldn't be feeling this, this is getting in the way, I can't be thinking this now if I have to focus on this, then what we're really doing is setting an example for everyone and everything that we should be treated that way, that we should be ignored, that we should be treated badly, that we should be brushed aside, that we shouldn't be valued or treated as important or treated as useful or helpful or in control. And ultimately, obviously, then we're doing completely the opposite of what we're trying to accomplish when we all just want positive attention. So what I want to hear from you now a little bit is what your experience was of trying to imagine being at your goal, at all of your goals, already being there next year. Did you have trouble with any particular area of your life, maybe, that you want to share? Was there a particular experience of accomplishment that you want to share that when you were thinking back, when we were doing the meditation, when you were imagining a time when you felt accomplished, is there a particular one you want to share that maybe will help us all get into that a little bit more, that feeling of having achieved something, or something that was sort of a seeming obstacle in the way, some thought or feeling and reaction when I said a certain area of life, and your immediate reaction was, I don't see how I could get there, or I don't know, I have trouble imagining that next year. Was there anything that you had trouble with, or anything that you really found easy to imagine that you want to share, anything that anyone wants to share, here, any personal experiences? It's not dire, just... give everyone the opportunity.
Alright, I'll bite.
Yeah.
Well, one of my goals, I gave myself short-term goals for my fitness transformation and all that, and like I was saying earlier, I'm almost just about halfway there.
Mm-hmm.
But my goal is to, by next year, to reach, like, my main goal. And you know, when you said that, like, that was, like, one of the first things that popped into my head, like, I can just imagine how accomplishing that might feel, because, you know, even when I was at my lightest weight, I wasn't in shape. It was, you know, I got this in the most unhealthy way possible, you know, just coming out of, you know, a very dark part of my life, and getting to the point where I was, and then all of a sudden, like, just making that decision, you know what, I'm going to join the gym, I'm going to start doing kickboxing, I'm going to start doing stuff that's going to make me feel better and do things for myself, that made a difference for me. So, you know, by next next year I would like to be at my main goal and, you know, continue from the path that I'm on.
That sounds great. Yeah. Thank you for sharing. Anyone else want to share any particular goals that they have? They could be less important if you feel it's like too personal, the larger things.
I've been through a lot in my life, and I've always had a conversation. I was always told, well, there's certain things you can't do, and you're never going to get at that, you get at this, and you're never going to find that one thing that makes you keep going. And I've been through a lot in my life as a child. Now I've been through different situations, been homeless before, and other things. It's a struggle, and one thing that when I was thinking about what I want to accomplish is I want to accomplish that no matter what I've been through, I can do it, and like I'm confident in myself that I'm gonna get through it, and like it's a big accomplishment that I can see myself that yes, I've been through everything, but despite what people say to me, I can and will succeed in my life.
Thank you for sharing.
Goals, it has to do with the direction of thoughts. And I teach with high school street boys. They're in a home and it's a rough situation. And I've been accused of being too nice to them, that they're walking all over me. So I don't know, I was just envisioning going into the classroom and trying to be mean. I don't know if I could do that because it's just like not my personality. So that's the only thing I'm struggling with right now, how to like...
Well, do you really need to be mean?
That's what I was told. I was told I'm too nice to them.
Yeah, but...
They're walking all over me.
But if they're... Okay, so let's go back to the idea that the way we treat ourselves sets the example for the way we're inclined to treat others, the way others are inclined to treat
these
us.
These are kids that I'm placed here because they're too young to go to jail. And so they get around everything. They know... You know, they see something and they know right away how to get into it. So that's the only thing I'm struggling with right now. Besides trying to I know this is what I'm doing. But that's what I'm trying to like. I'm envisioning myself actually just tomorrow walking into the classroom and kind of trying to be more stern and less like joking around. Used to being smarter.
But you see.
So that's what I'm like, trying to visualize.
But you see. You're making the base camp the peak. Like when you're climbing a mountain, you want to get to the top. Like let's say you want to get to the top. If you want to get to the top of the mountain, and then you're saying, well, tonight I'd like to get to this part of the mountain so I can, you know, set up base camp and then I'll continue tomorrow. You're making your base camp your peak. In the sense that you're saying, I'm trying to imagine tomorrow being stern. But that's not your goal. Your goal is to actually have a situation where they're listening to you. Which might not be being stern. You don't know that yet. So what you really want to imagine is that you go into the classroom and you actually feel like they're listening to you. It wouldn't matter how you get there. If they're listening to you, you'll have accomplished your goal. Maybe that means you're actually nice to them. Maybe it means you're joking. Maybe it means you're stern. You don't know that yet. But you know that you want to get the result that they're listening to you. So you want to stay focused on what your actual goal is. Then as far as that's concerned, if you don't feel like they're listening to you, do you feel like they're not listening to you? So you feel like they're listening to you?
No, I don't feel like they're listening to me.
You don't feel like they're listening to you?
Not all of them. One or two in front and the rest of us.
Uh-huh. And what does that make you feel?
Frustrated.
Mm-hmm. So where might you not be listening to yourself where you're frustrated with it? Where have you been telling yourself you have to do certain things besides here? Because obviously it's true here that you feel like you have to be more stern rather than it would be really nice they listen to me. Like that's a total different destination, you see. Because it's not like I have to be this way to get this result. I don't
have to
be able to get it.
Control of the class.
But you see you're being told this because you're thinking it. You are thinking you need more control of the class. You're not liking that they're not listening to you. if people are telling you it, notice that when people tell us things, they usually are touching upon something that we have thought on some level. It's not like it's completely out of the blue. So there is the sense that you already feel like you have to figure out a way to get control of the class and they're not listening to you. Where in your life do you feel like you don't, where else in your life might you feel like you don't have control and you feel like you don't know how to get control over it? Is there any other place in your life or not so much? There might not be any other place in your life, I'm just curious because there are usually themes. Might not be anything. No?
I have three daughters, so sometimes I lose control. I'm used to game with that, but that's okay. No, it's just in the classroom.
Why are you in that job? And how do you feel about being in that job?
Oh, it's a good job. It's a good job. Mm-hmm. But there's no other options. It's close to home, and it is an easier job than being in another situation. It's just this group of kids that have come in, and they come in, and they go out, and they come in, and they go out. And like I said, they're gang-related, and the courts put them there. It's basically a baby jail. So I'm coming from a middle school situation, so I have to, like, I have to stop being the coddler and be an authority. Right? It's the transition that I'm.
That's interesting. So why did you move from middle school to here?
Sandy.
What would your ideal scenario be?
That I'm teaching the high school math, because that's what I like, and they're interested in it. And they're not just knowing that they're just spending their months and then they'll be out in the street again. Mm-hmm. That's what I care about. None of them really care about the education, but...
But you see that you're helping them in... I mean, I'm sure coming in they probably are thinking that. But if you're thinking that they're thinking that, then it's like my example of the significant other earlier, when you're telling someone, you have to do this, or it really bothers me when you do this, but you're not really believing that they're going to change, then they get the message that you don't really believe they're going to change. If they feel like you believe in them, you would have a much better chance of actually getting them to listen to you. If they feel like you believe that they won't end up back on the street, that it's a possibility that they could end up in a different situation. If they feel like you believe that, then you'll be one of the few people in their life who probably does. And that's going to get them to listen to you. Because most people in their lives probably feel like they're going to end up back in the street, and they feel like they're going to end up back in the street. But if someone believed that there was a possibility that they might not, that they might end up in a different scenario that's better for them, that would be like a light at the end of the tunnel kind of situation. That would be like, why does this person believe in me? And then they would want to pay attention to you. And it starts with the way that you think about them. If you're thinking they're going to end up right back on the street, then it doesn't seem worth giving them your attention. There's no reason to be fully present there. Then they have no reason to be fully present to you, because you're not even fully present with them. It feels like everyone's given up on them anyway. What's the point? Why do they need to be there? But if you seem to believe in them, that it's even a possibility, then you see you're setting a different destination there. There's a whole different feeling created. Then you're more likely to be more present, to put a different kind of energy into the situation. It's not like, oh, I'm going to do this and go through the motions, but it's hopeless anyway. It's going to be, there's a reason for me to be here as fully as possible, because I might actually get some of these people into a different situation in life. I could potentially have that effect. And then they're going to see you being more present to them in a way that most people aren't. And then they're going to have reason to be present to you. It changes the whole dynamic in the classroom. So... thank you everyone for sharing something. So what I want to do right now is just step back into that meditative place, that place of what it would feel like to have accomplished our goals, just to reaffirm those destinations. Then we're going to quickly offer you an opportunity to help you reach some of those goals if you want to take advantage of that. And then you'll be free to actually experience accomplishing these goals. Starting, going out and applying some of the stuff you learned tonight. So first I just want to step into that feeling of what it would be like to have accomplished those goals. We're just going to do that for about 4 or 5 minutes. So whenever you're ready, you can close your eyes, you can get back into that calmer place. Orlando, do you want to dim the lights quickly? So it's just going to be like 4 or 5 minutes. I'm just going to step back into that feeling of January 15th, 2016, looking back. And seeing that we've accomplished everything we set out to in 2015. So let's step back into that feeling of accomplishment, what it feels like to have set out to do something that's meaningful for you, and to actually do it, and to see the changes taking place, and know that you were in control of that, that you set out to do that, that you have the power to repeat that over and over again in different areas of your life, whenever you want, because you made this happen. So step back into that feeling, and let's project it again into our different areas of our lives. So imagine you're looking back at 2015. Imagine what it feels like to be exactly where you want to be in terms of your body, fitness, self-image, body image. To have achieved all the goals in that area of your life over the course of the last year that you set out to achieve. Now imagine what it feels like again to have accomplished everything that you would have wanted to accomplish in 2015 in the area of your living situation. And feel what it feels like to have accomplished everything you would have wanted to accomplish in the last year in your career. And to have accomplished everything you would have wanted to accomplish in the area of finances, to have achieved all the goals that you have had for yourself in that area. 2015. Imagine what it feels like to have accomplished everything you would have wanted to accomplish in the area of family. And to feel that sense of accomplishment in the area of community. And to feel that sense of accomplishment in the area of friendships. And to feel that sense of in the area of your relationship or relationships. Imagine you're taking a moment in January 2016 and you're looking back. The goals you set in January 2015, and you're suddenly aware of how many of them you actually reached, and you're just taking a moment and reflecting on that, of how many good things have happened, how many big positive changes you've made, beginning with small ones and working your way up as they built upon themselves. imagine how triumphant you feel looking back, how powerful you feel, that you could do this whenever you want. You can accomplish whatever you want by stepping into the feeling of what it would be like to have already done it and have had it work out exactly as you would like it to. Recreate this feeling of accomplishment whenever you want and build on it with new accomplishments. Now let's rewind back to January 15th, 2015, back into this room with that energy and readiness to achieve all those goals that you've set for yourself. So now we have a special opportunity for those of you who are here today. So we're offering a 6-month transformation package, mind, body, and soul. Where you will have 2 sessions a month, two health coaching sessions a month, every other week, and that will be alternating with 2 sessions with me, so that we can get into even more areas of our lives, that we could delve into the deeper underlying things that are holding us back and make bigger changes, so that we're not just looking at the health and fitness, but are actually looking at all areas of our lives and how that might even play into the health and fitness and how you're eating and how you're taking care of yourself. That we can get at any limiting beliefs you have, any ways you've been operating that you could make changes to, that you could actually achieve everything you've set out to achieve for the coming year. So we have the 2 health coaching sessions, we have the 2 life guidance sessions per month, and you would get recordings of the sessions, of the life guidance sessions, so that you can listen back to them and hear the things that you've learned from them and be able to put them into practice and remind yourself of the things we talked about. You also would get 4 personal training sessions with Orlando or someone else here, and so that you actually can be putting some of the stuff we're talking about into action in terms of fitness goals. And you will basically have a team of people on your side helping you to achieve your goals here, because you've got Nicole, Orlando, and me all helping you out in different aspects of your life and your eating, fitness goals, and overcoming any limiting beliefs and stepping into where you want to be. Nicole or Orlando, you want to describe some of the other things you're going to be getting with this package and the special opportunities? So far, I
have wife sense, right?
Yeah.
As soon as I walk in, I'm like, you.
So far, I've talked about the 2 health coaching sessions, the 2 life guidance sessions, and the 4 personal training sessions. You want to describe the rest?
Sure. Okay, so he told you about, it's like the 6-month transformation some of you are doing, plus Jonathan, which is awesome. So you have this team of people just working on you and your life. So moving on to the other stuff, every month we're going to be having 2 workshops. So this is a workshop, but they're really on a diverse, with so many different topics. So this is our first one. The next one is going to be with Sifu Greg Pichardo, who's a second generation Bruce Lee student, and he's going to be doing an interactive self-defense workshop. The one after that is going to be a couples massage workshop right around the time of Valentine's Day.
And after that, we're having an eating psychologist come in and do a workshop on beating emotional eating. So we have lots of different topics, all loosely related to fitness, wellness, martial arts, all the things that we're about. We also have monthly like fun events, so community events. Those can be anything from, you know, where we're doing, you know, healthy food potlucks to like field day type of things, you know, anything fun. Some of them are family oriented, some of them are more, you know, for grown-ups. So with the health coaching part of it, you actually get little gifts. Some of you know about the little gifts Orlando has given you, and so you might get, you know, some workout equipment for at home, or, you know, we'll say, hey, you really need to have more green vegetables in your diet. Here is some kale. Cook it tonight. Send me a text. Tell me how you liked it. You get membership in the Fight for Fitness and the Inspirational Life Guidance Facebook groups. And so this isn't just liking our page, it's different. We're actually going to have an interactive Facebook group where members only get to discuss among each other and ask questions. And you'll have not just us in there and other Fight for Fitness trainers and staff, but people like Jonathan are joining in. So you might ask a question that, you know, Jonathan might be the best person to answer, and you'll have him answer. Or you might have Steve Greg Pichardo answer if it's a martial arts question. And you also have access. We have meditations that are going to be twice a week. We're going to put them before and after popular classes, one in the evening, one on the weekend. And, you know, it'll be 20, 30 minutes. You come, you're guided through a different meditation technique each time, and there's a discussion about it. And the point is to kind of find something that resonates with you. For some people, it's the, you know, humming and, you know, really quiet type of meditation, and that really works. And other people are like, oh, that's kind of, I can't do it. And so maybe more of an active meditation or visualization. But I promise there's something that resonates with you. And you'll also get our e-newsletter, which is a lot of, you know, we'll give links to articles, we'll give you tips to try at home, things you can try in your life, things you can try with your diet. And so it's a lot of, you know, information to help you make the right decisions when you're not physically in the studio. And you'll also get an instructional video each month. It's kind of like having Orlando do a personal training with you via YouTube video. So it's one that you can click on and work through at home on the days you can't make it. So, is there anything I should add? Because I'm not sure what you guys already said.
I only really said the, like I said, the two health coaching, two life guidance, and four personal training. So anything else that you want to say, go ahead.
So for those of you who aren't familiar with health coaching, it includes nutrition and lifestyle counseling. So the lifestyle portion includes things like stress management, sleep, doing things about any health conditions that you might be dealing with, or maybe something that runs in your family you're trying to prevent, things like that.
And then obviously that will be alternating with sessions with me, where we'll be able to go into what would you like instead of the thing that you're getting caught up in. But ultimately we don't even realize when we're doing it, so that might sound very straightforward and simplistic right now, but as we're going through the way that you're talking about your week and the way that things have happened in your life, and we start to discuss, well, if that's happening for you, then what are you doing internally that's actually bringing that external situation about when it comes to your body, when it comes to your relationships, when it comes to your career, when it comes to everything? So we'll actually be addressing everything, and then being able to have it be put into more, right into practice when it comes to health coaching, when it comes to personal training, that when it comes to that area of your life, you're already putting it into practice while you're still able to delve into the deeper things that might be holding you back from actually achieving these goals when you're coming to me. So anything that might have stopped you in the past, we'll get to that now, and you won't be stopping you anymore. And you'll get to those goals that you have set for yourselves and here potentially in the next 6 months. Not just the year, but obviously we'll get you started so that all the goals that you set for yourself today, that you'll actually be able to get to them, and that when you are in January 2016 looking back, then you actually will have accomplished everything you set out to accomplish. And if it feels right to sign up for this to help you get there, then that would be great. And if not, then whatever gets you there, because ultimately you're getting those directions now from your internal GPS. Once you set a destination, then you want to listen to, well, what feels right. and then address anything that might be in the way of that feeling good. If you can't imagine it feeling good, don't do it. And if you can imagine it feeling good, it's probably a good direction to go. And then you just want to address any concerns that you have. So go with whatever feels right for you. Ultimately, for today, there is a special offer for this package where it's only $8.97 per month for the 6 months, as opposed to the $9.47 if you don't sign up today per month for 6 months. So ultimately, you save $300 if you sign up today before you leave for this package. Otherwise, obviously, it'll still be available
till the end of the month.
Till the end of the month, but it is an exclusive one-time offer for now, a limited-time offer for now. That this particular thing is being offered, and we'll see how this goes as to whether anything like this would be offered again. Where it's actually a team of people, where it's Nicole, Orlando, and me all together collaborating to help you reach your goals. And then obviously there'll be different things in the future, but nothing quite like this.
So just a note, sorry I have to step out for most of it. He's really the boss here. So just a note about the workshops in general, since this is the first one. So we pair up with professionals who really connect well with what we do, with our philosophies, with the information and the services we try to bring you. And so we bring them in and they do their workshop. And we try to find some way to collaborate with them to bring you something really neat each time and to, then give some sort of, special giveaway or discount or something for the people who show up. So just to frame that, and that's how these tend to run. We try to get something special that you can't really get anywhere else when you're writing, finding people who are willing to work with us.
And thank you for inviting me to speak here.
Thank you so much for coming.
So before you leave, and obviously keep thinking amongst yourselves.
I want to wrap up with saying thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Also, start paying attention to Fight for Fitness website and also Facebook. You don't have it yet. If you have, click on it. I want to like it. We're going to put a lot of basically what we're doing out there. And on the website, you want to click in to see what is it that we do exactly. Like, we have a lot of information in there. We have our blogs that you can follow. And basically, this is just the beginning. This is day one on this. It's first time. All the stuff that we're going to keep adding and stuff is going to be more and more and more in depth. And as we open up and become, more us, how it's going to be, a lot more fun. We are going to have a lot more events. We are going to have a lot more fun events, too. And a lot more just more of this, more interactive. And yeah, it's what it is. All right, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Thank you.